Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism, and here I'm going to give you a word of encouragement. So many people, when they hear my videos or hear my views, then they get a bit puzzled, and they get say, oh, the general people or the common man say this thing and this man says something different. So they then start get puzzled and they don't know what to do, you know, they are in a perplexed state. And so those who make use of their common sense and who consult their inner man, the Christ, only they can get through this confusion. Otherwise, those people who consult books and they want to know, see a book before they believe where it is written and all that nonsense, only they get lost. Remember that St. Paul has said clearly that the word of God cannot be written down in ink on paper. That means it cannot be written down as it is in the Bible. So Bible is not the word of God. Word of God you receive through revelation. So unless you are given the common sense to interpret the parables, interpret what it means, so you cannot have gospel. Gospel is not letters, it is spirit. And spirit, as you know, is not bound by anything. It is free. So you receive the gospel free from our Father and you give it free, not sell it as these hireling people are doing in churches. In churches, these people are employed. They get paid in mammon. And how can God then entrust them with the gospel, which is given free and received free? So people who make business out of the churches and other things, as some people do in third world country like Ghana, Africa, mostly. I was in Ghana 14 years, and over there people have made it a business to open a church and to fleece the people. Singing songs and making noise doesn't make you a religious person. A religious person is one who can explain the word of God. The word of God is explained when your inner man is alive, is not dead. Remember, I gave that simile of the Samaritan man who was carrying a lamb, and Christ Jesus said what he will do with the lamb. His workers said where he will go. He will slaughter the lamb and eat it. Jesus said, will he eat the lamb while he's still alive? No, he must kill it first, as the Jews were killing the people by making them Jews of the ritual, which John the Baptist called the brood of vipers, these temple priests. So temple priest first kill the bird, I kill the person, and then they fleece him, eat him. Widow's mite is a typical example how she paid her meager earning into the chest, not knowing that it is going into the coffers of the Antichrist. So such is the thing, that people do not consult their inner man. They consult the dead books. Dead books make you dead person. As the dead burying their dead mean, the university professors who take the skin of the words without understanding. So these people, they are the dead burying their dead. So the men of spirit, they are very rare to come across. And how rare they are, that St. Thomas said, one in thousand will know the word of God, and two in 10,000, because the one who knows it when he preaches it, the people will say, hey, this man is a heretic or a crazy man, don't listen to him. So they will dissuade the other people not to listen to him. This thing is happening to me in Reading. And in 1984-85, I went to the house of a priest and met him. He was in India, going there for charity and other work. So I explained to him the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. And when I went to his church on one Sunday, and there was sermon about you cannot serve Mammon and God at the same time, I was just getting ready what he will say, you know. And what he said with the opening words, there is among you is sitting a man who distributes his own literature article. I used to cyclostyle it and give it to the people. Don't take anything from him. He is a heretic. So there was another churchman who was a Church of England. He did PhD in mathematics, and he happened to become a priest too. And same thing when I explained to him the five husbands of this Samaritan woman, he stood up from his chair, being ordained as the minister in the Church of England. I declare you a heretic. So such are the things that you will meet. So don't be worried, because gospel is not for them. It is gospel is for the living, common man. Common man who is of the street, who is a farmer, who is a sweeping this road, who have not been to a university. He has more common sense than those people who attend universities and get degrees in theology. They don't get a degree in theology. They get degrees in the letters. The gospel is of spirit. Nobody can pass it on. Remember, Jesus could not pass gospel on to Saint Peter. It's only at the Pentecost that he was given his wage of Holy Spirit, that he was happiest of all the persons, that he started preaching gospel straight away. So gospel, nobody can give you unless you get it by the grace of our Father. And who gets it? One who willeth. If you have no will, you won't get it. You have to seek. If you are not capable of seeking, if you have no desire, it is not lying on a platter or in a book as these dead people read. When they read Bible, they say, oh, we have got the gospel. If you ask them simple question, in whose name John the Baptist baptized men in water, or why he did not baptize a woman, or when Jesus baptized his workers, even their ministers are at a loss. They have, you see them, their faces when they ask them. John the Baptist said, the one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit, and ask them, when Jesus baptized them, his workers in the Holy Spirit, then you see their faces, how they get all blank, you know. And such is this gospel. And the gospel is much worse in India. In India, the second anointed Christ came, and over there, the people are being most brainwashed. And over there, the last Christ on earth, that was the sixth Satguru or Christ, Tegh Bahadur Ji, on earth. He was the last light of the anointed second Christ, Nanak. The sixth Satguru Tegh Bahadur. And he gave the last sermon, ultimatum. And he said, you know, one in a million will know gospel. So you can well imagine that in the Middle East it was one in 1,000.